Patton and Magnus Sykes. So I wanted to talk right now about passing judgment. You know those people that pass judgment before they've heard the whole story? Before they've heard both sides of a story or a situation? You know what I'm talking about? You know, when someone is put into a situation, either they're asked their opinion or they're told a story and then they feel that they need to give their opinion, but they don't have all the facts, they don't have all the details. And I notice that this goes on usually in male-female relationships. When there's some drama or some stuff going on with a couple, the friends on either side usually take the side that they're on. And I've noticed that over the years, like I think early in my life, I realized that, wait a minute. Most people tell a biased story in the first place. So they're going to tell a story to make themselves look good, make themselves look better, or so that their friends or whoever it is will take their side. And I learned to tell unbiased stories. And at the same time, I also learned that people are always going to usually follow their lead emotion. They usually won't step back and say, you know what, wait a minute. Because I've been involved in a few situations that, you know, that I didn't ask to be involved in. You know, where friends came to me and asked me my opinion. See, because, you know, I'm all about, hey, it's his and her business. At least stay out of it. But when your friend brings you into it because they need your advice or they just curious, they're wondering what you think, I think that you should have a broad, perspective so that you can give a proper answer. You get what I'm saying? So, like, I remember I had a homeboy come to me and, you know, he was having problems with his wife. His wife was acting up, going tit for tat with him. And, you know, with him telling me the story, from his perspective, his biased perspective that he's telling me the story, oh, I should jump up, hoop and holler and be like, oh man, she did that to you? But I'm like, well, wait a minute, what did you do? What is her reasons for doing this? Why did she say this? Why did she say it that way? What did she mean? What did she say she meant? See, I ask questions like this because so many people just try to get you on their side or just, you know, and then you got the people that, you know, they're looking for an honest answer, but you got their friends that are so emotionally invested in being their friend that whoever goes against their friend is absolutely evil and wrong and an asshole and all this other shit. I notice that happens with women a lot. You know, a girl can tell her friends what happened between her and her boyfriend, and all of a sudden the guy's an asshole. But wait a minute, you know your girlfriend? Is she a total angel? You tell me she ain't got no bitch laced up in her? Get the fuck out of here. So, my friends know that when they call me, they're gonna get a goddamn honest ass answer. You know what I'm saying? I went through some shit last year, and it was funny because people were forming opinions, but as soon as I told my story and let it be known what was going on from my end, it was like, oh, wait a minute. Oh, for real? Yeah. Oh, shit. Yeah, exactly. People accept a one-person story as the gospel truth without asking another person. So I'm basically doing this video to say, listen, people, I've been a victim of it. People passing judgment on me. I'm sure you've been a victim of it. Shit, I'm sure all of you out there, even myself, has passed judgment on someone in the past because they heard one side of a particular fucking story. You know, they say there's, you know, his side, her side, and the truth. And I don't believe you ever get the total truth because no one usually has the perspective to see something going on and watch without the other people knowing. Because, you know, when people are being observed and they know they're being observed, they doctor how they act in their movements. But when people don't know, you know, if you could be a fly on the wall, that's when you find out the truth. But still, you want to get to the deepest amount of truth that you can. So whether it's two homeboys that got a disagreement, two girlfriends, a girlfriend and a homeboy, whether it's your girlfriend, boyfriend, mother, father, whoever it is, you need to talk to both parties before you pass judgment. That's all I got to say. 1 million subscribers. Woo!